extremely disturbing that there is this kind of retaliation and hate against anyone who would stand for basic Palestinian human rights. Not entirely unexpected considering the political environment that we're in.
Zainab Chaudhry is a director of the Maryland chapter of the Council on American Islamic Relations. She says in just the past 3 or 4 days alone, her office has received reports from Palestinian and Muslim students that they are being harassed at bus stops, getting threatening mail, and even threats of being doxxed.
Now, this is unfortunately a trend in the United States where when one tragedy strikes or misinformation begins to spread, hate crimes associated with that identity begin to spike. We saw after COVID in 2020 a 77% increase in anti-Asian American hate crimes. During Trump's rhetoric about what was going on at the Mexican border, we saw a 21% increase in anti-Latino or Hispanic hate crimes back in 2018. And after 9/11 back in 2001, there was a 94% increase in anti-Muslim hate crimes.
Hassan Hamad is a Palestinian-American and the president of the Islamic Society of Baltimore. He says the world is trying to portray this as a Muslim problem, when in reality, Muslims, Christians, and Jewish people in Gaza are dying.
And now, the fear is that anyone that's going to open their mouth and says, we stand with the people, the innocent people in Gaza, that there's going to be retaliation to them. Oh, you support hate. No, we support peace. We support peace.
Hamad says not one religion condones what is happening.
No one supports hate. No one's saying that what's happening is okay. What we are saying is you cannot pick a side and say we're going to support the Israelis when you've completely ignored for the last 16 years that the people in Gaza have been deprived of regular amenities that every single one of us here is afforded as an American citizen.